It's 9 o'clock. Athens International Radio, 104.4 FM.
I'm Louis Kodamopoulos.
And I'm Alexia Mbrazic.
I'm Nikki Achimastos.
And I'm Barney Spender. Kalispera.
I'm Tom Alexopoulos.
And I'm Thimis Tsiliopoulos.
Antonis Karayanakis in the house.
My name is Theo Ioannou. I'll be joining you. I'll be your host until midnight.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is Kerry Jacobs with this weekend's Afternoon Delight.
On 104.4 FM, Athens International Radio.
Good morning, it's 9 o'clock on Thursday, October 28th, and I'm Louis Konomopoulos with the news on Athens International Radio 104.4. October 28th today, a national holiday for Greeks with 64th anniversary of Ochi Day. The national holiday commemorates Greece's resounding no to Italy's fascist dictator Benito Mussolini's demand for free passage to invade the country during World War II. Ochi Day will be celebrated throughout the country with church services and parades. In Thessaloniki, the festivities conclude this morning with a military parade in the presence of the President of Hellenic Republic, Kostis Stefanopoulos, and the Minister of Defense, Pilios Spiliotopoulos. In Athens, a high school students' parade will take place this morning at 11 in front of the Greek Parliament in Syntagma Square. The indisputable and perennial importance of the 1940 epic is stated in the political party's messages for the 64th anniversary of Ochi Day. Prime Minister Kostas Karamanlis in his message states that the national anniversary of October 28th coincides with a historic milestone of our continent since Europe is united with a basis of common values and convictions, leaves behind in the past disunions and hardships, and decides to move forward to boldly construct a vision of a common future of security, peace, and prosperity for all its citizens. The president of PASOK, Yorgos Papandreou, in his message underlines that the 1940 epic and the monumental national resistance that followed are among the brilliant pages of our modern history. The memory of the past is a necessary condition in order to understand the importance of critical events that define the future of world history, but also to realize our responsibilities at times when we have to decide for the future, Papandreou states. The Communist Party of Greece, in its message for the anniversary of October 28, notes to the fact that in 1940, the Greek people blocked the Italian fascist imperialism aggressor's troops to flee in one of the many armaments that the people can behold its right as long as it stands and acts. The Party of Synaspismos, in its message, states, "We pay our respects to the exaltation and the sacrifices of the Greek people that fought in the first line of the war to beat fascism 64 years ago. The Greek youth should keep the historic memory of the national resistance alive and their visions for the freedom and the welfare of our country." Special traffic restrictions will be implemented in central Athens due to the major high school students' parade. Starting at 10 a.m., roads will be gradually cut off. Traffic will be suspended on Amalias, Panepistimio, and Vasilisis Sofias Avenues. Mitropolis Street has been closed to traffic from 6 this morning due to the religious service held at the Mitropoli Cathedral. Also, traffic will be disrupted in the municipalities of Peristeri, Kalithea, Nea Smyrni, Paliofaliron, Tavros, Alimos, and Daphne due to the pupils' parades. Bus and trolley routes will be changed. Meanwhile, traffic police is on full alert to facilitate Athenians leaving the city for the 4-day break due to 28 October national holiday. Extraordinary measures will apply as of 2 in the afternoon until 10 at night on all national roads. Police helicopters will provide extra surveillance of the national road network by air. Also, trucks weighing over 1.5 tons will be banned from circulating on the national roads between 4 and 9 p.m. Greece says it would not cede even slightly its sovereignty to Turkey after accusing Ankara of almost daily violations of its air and maritime space in the past few days. Deputy government spokesman Evangelos Andonaros said, quote, "Turkey has its own positions and we stand by our own." The Greek military authorities reported new Turkish violations yesterday on Greek airspace in the Aegean Sea. Greek President Kostis Stefanopoulos said in the northern city of Thessaloniki that Greece does not have negative thoughts about Turkey, but that Ankara must be careful with its policy, foreign policy towards Greece and Cyprus. Greek Prime Minister Kostas Karamanlis leaves for Rome tomorrow to participate in the ceremony for the signing of a new European constitution by the EU's 25 leaders. Meanwhile, the row over the makeup of incoming President José Manuel Barroso's commission came to head in the European Parliament yesterday. Barroso, who was facing defeat at the investiture vote, withdrew his proposed team of commissioners and was granted a one-month delay. The move comes after fierce criticism over his choice of the right-wing Italian Rocco Buttiglione to the post of EU Justice and Civil Rights Commissioner. A number of problems were caused by the sudden rainstorm early this morning in the western suburbs of Athens. The fire brigade received 50 calls for flooded basements in Aspropyrgo, Elefsina, Haidari, Peristeri, and Kolono. The bridge at Kalirois was also flooded, and two motorists were rescued after being trapped in their vehicles. In Sepolia, an old building collapsed, causing damage to a parked car, and 110 patients of the Dromakaito Hospital were evacuated after three wings of the hospital were flooded. The government's incomes policy for 2005 will envision pay rises above the inflation rate. This according to Finance Minister Yorgos Alavoskoufis, speaking after meeting with representatives of the civil servants union, ADEVI. The minister said that the government would also raise the tax-exempt income ceiling to 11,000 euros. ADEVI requested an increase in funding for education and health. Borrowing by households stood at an annualized rate of 28.4% in August from 28.2% a month earlier. Bank of Greece said household borrowing in the form of mortgages and consumer loans totaled 46.9%, representing 28.5% of gross domestic product. The International Olympic Committee has urged Beijing to ensure the city is ready to host the 2008 Games well in advance. The Chinese capital was warned not to follow the example set by Athens, where preparations for the Games were in progress right up to the opening day on August 13. Executive Director of the IOC, Gilbert Feli, told the Chinese, quote, "Don't copy Athens, do your own games." And in international news, a methane blast in a mineshaft in Russia's Siberia killed at least 10 people and injured 30 this morning. The blast ripped through the mine as a 45-strong repair team was patching up the mine near Russia's border with Mongolia. The emergencies ministry in Moscow earlier said 240 people were underground when the explosion occurred this morning. Russian news agencies reported that 9 brigades of rescue workers controlled by the local governor were searching for survivors. Accidents are common in Russia's loss-making collieries, many of which date back to the dictator Joseph Stalin's 1920s industrialized drive and where safety procedures are largely unchanged since Soviet times. The weather forecast for Athens and Vicinity: cloudy showers and sunny spells are forecast in parts of the country, with rain mainly in the west and south, where storms were held earlier today. Winds southerly moderate. Maximum temperatures will remain high for the time of the year. Temperatures in Athens will reach 24 degrees Celsius, that's 75 degrees Fahrenheit. And in Thessaloniki, it will reach a high of 21 degrees Celsius, 73 Fahrenheit. And you were listening to the news here at 9 o'clock. Good Morning Athens returns on its regular scheduled program tomorrow at 9 a.m. Stay tuned for a half-hour special program on the Greek national holiday, Orchidei. Thank you. 3 a.m. October 28, 1940, the Italian minister of Athens called on Greek Prime Minister Ioannis Metaxas at his Athens home to deliver an ultimatum demanding passage for Italian troops through Greek territory to certain unspecified strategic points. The ultimatum warned that any resistance would be crushed by force of arms. The ultimatum was to expire at 6 a.m. that day, but at 5:30 a.m., Italian troops from Albania were already advancing into northwestern Greece. Metaxas' immediate reply to the ultimatum was one word, "Ohi," which simply means no. And since that day, October 28th has been celebrated as a national holiday by the Greek people. Italian dictator Mussolini had completely underestimated the intense patriotism of the Greeks and had expected them to submit without a struggle. Public opinion in Greece received the declaration of war with enthusiasm and relief despite the odds. The immediate effect of the Italian ultimatum was to induce a national unity that the Greeks had seldom experienced in their long history. The morale of the Greek people reached unknown heights and the whole nation seemed prepared to make every sacrifice. For the next few months, Greece was to experience her finest hours. To the astonishment of the world, the Italians, despite their superiority in manpower and military hardware, were driven back into Albania within a few days. Meanwhile, it was becoming apparent that Hitler would have to come to the rescue of Mussolini. On April 6, 1940, the Germans invaded, and in 20 days, Greece was in the hands of the enemy. The unexpected resistance by Greece, however, had upset Hitler's timetable and had weakened his forces. The atmosphere of patriotic fervor was inspired by the emotionally charged songs of Sophia Vembo, as we're hearing in the background. She was a symbol of Greek resistance. In the period of 1941 to 1942, Vembo entertained the remnants of the Greek army in exile in Egypt. Sophia Vembo was born on February 10, 1910, in Calliope of eastern Thrace. Her records were taken to the front by the Greek Defense Ministry and played to soldiers fighting. Even the BBC played her songs then. Her voice lit the flames in the hearts of Greeks and filled them with hopes for a victory. She was arrested one evening at the theater she was performing in Athens by the Gestapo. Songs like Mussolini, you were gonna tear you all apart, you Italians are so tough, but it's obviously just a bluff, we're gonna push you all the way back to Rome, were some of the words in the songs that she sang. It was Vembo who sang all those songs, and that's why they dubbed her the Victory Singer. With a smile on their lips, our boys go to war, and the Italians run as they give them what they deserve, says one of her songs. And it was to the sound of this song, and many like it, that the boys set off for the front. The songs of Sophia Vembo that animated people at the rear and the soldiers in the battlefields have remained unforgettable. She died in 1978 at the age of 68. Let's listen now to another song from Vembo.
Κυκή, σαπάν, σαπάν στην βόρτα. Λένε τα παιδιά μας όλα. Έλα παραβόρε για να σιγώ κι εγώ. Γιατί δεν βγαίνεις να σιγώ. Ρε γιατί μας κάνεις όλα εγώ. Για χιόνια, λάσπες και βροχές, κέριε λάσπες και
Hellas army of 80,000 men, supported by around 30 old biplanes and no tanks, heroically defended the country against Mussolini's army of 2 million men, 400 planes, and hundreds of tanks and armored vehicles. The Greeks performed what the whole world hailed as a miracle and gave the Allies the first victory of the war. For it was not until the gigantic military machine created by a nation of 80 million Germans was added to that of Italy's 44 million people that the valiant 9 million Greeks were overpowered. Hellas ultimately lost more lives as a percentage of her population than any other country except Russia, over 700,000 dead with a population of just under 9 million. This compared to Russia with 27 million dead and a population of 160 million, or the U.S. with 300,000 dead and a population of just over 130 million. The under-equipped and half-starved Greek troops made many heroic defenses, such as the siege of Metaxas Line, a system of defensive bunkers which the Germans had to give up trying to take by force and ultimately took by starving the defenders out. After the Greeks emerged from their bunkers, the Germans actually held a parade during which they marched past the emaciated Greeks as a sign of respect for their fighting skills and tenacious bravery. There they dismissed the Greek troops, taking no prisoners, but letting the officers and men go home. This was the only time during the entire war that such an honor was paid to a foe by the German army. It was against this background that there was, in October 1940, a feeling of panic and despair throughout Europe. And it was at this point that the Greeks, supported by the heroic women who literally performed miracles to keep their men supplied during one of the severest winters ever recorded, gave Europe and the world the first hope-inspiring victory that historians to this day continue to say defies explanation. "Greece is dead. Long live Greece," screamed the headlines as valiant Hellas, overpowered by the combined forces of Italy and Germany, finally fell in April of 1941, 6 full months after Italy's October 1940 invasion. Today, October 28th, Greece celebrates Oichi Day, a very important historical anniversary, as we said. Oichi Day reminds the nation of the bravery and dignity which the government of Prime Minister Metaxas said no to Italy's demand to pass its troops through Greece in 1941, this leading the neutral country into the World War. Schools, veteran soldiers, the Army, Navy, and Air Force, and survivors from the resistance movement annually march before officials through the country's main streets, carrying the Greek flag in a show of remembrance, unity, and respect. Themis Tsiopoulos recounts this historic day.
Εδώ ραδιοφωνικός σταθμός Αθηνών. Μεταδίδομεν το πρώτο ανακοινωθέν του Ελληνικού Γενικού Στρατηγίου.
This is the Athens radio station. We are broadcasting the first report of the Greek general headquarters. The Italian armed forces have been attacking our covering unit on the Albanian frontier since 5:30 in the morning. Our forces are defending the Greek soil. On the night of 27 to 28 October, the Italian ambassador to Athens, Emanuele Grazzi, arrived at the residence of Prime Minister Ioannis Metaxas to deliver an ultimatum from his government to Greece. Italy demanded the unhindered passage of Italian troops through Greece and the seizure of strategic locations. Ioannis Metaxas, a royalist general whose small party had been elected to parliament only to usurp authority and establish a dictatorial regime, was, however, above all else a nationalist and a firm believer in the power of the Allies. At 3 o'clock in the morning of October 28, Metaxas, echoing the feelings and will of the Greek people, rejected the impudent Italian demands and unhesitantly answered with a historic Ochi, the resounding no that meant that Greece would not kowtow to the demands of Italy's fascist government. An evidently shaken Grazzi, a man who admired and loved Greece, bade Metaxas good night and apologized. The morning found him and his family on a return trip to Rome, protected by diplomatic convention. Thus, the war between Italy and Greece, which the Greek government had made so many efforts to avoid, became reality. The dawn found the Greek people celebrating, while sirens wailed and the Italian Air Force, the Regia Aeronautica, pounded Greek cities from above. Men, women, and children rushed to the streets, overcome by the frenetic joy that resembled not so much a war, but a feast. At the same time, units of the Greek army had already begun moving towards the frontier with Albania, through which poured Mussolini's troops. The Italians had in fact begun crossing the frontier before Grazzi delivered his ultimatum. Under cover of darkness, two Italian army corps and an independent mounted division, aided by units of Albanian irregulars, crossed the frontier in three columns, numbering a total of almost 100,000 men. The aim was to attempt an advance along the coastal plain of Epiros, where Italian light tanks could exploit the relatively flat terrain, and a parallel push along the craggy and treacherous mountains of the Pindus Range. The Greek strategy was based on an elastic defense that would give time for mobilization and repositioning of forces from other locations. Despite stubborn resistance, the Greeks fell back, and as the Italian troops moved forward, Albanian irregulars and bandits plundered the locals now behind Italian lines. Unopposed and unobserved, the Alpini division Giulia made a dash for the only road connecting western and eastern Greece over the mountains. Luckily, they were spotted on the 2nd of November by the crew of a Greek wrecking plane through a break in the dense cloud. Before long, the Greeks crushed the Italian advance at the river Calamas. The river, swollen by floods and rain, became the grave for thousands of Italian soldiers. From that point on, the Greek army pushed the Italians back into Albania and proceeded on its own advance into areas populated mostly by Greeks. By the end of the winter, the front had stabilized.
Thimis Heliopoulos with that story. In April 27, 1941, 6 months after Metaxas said no to Italy's demands and entered Greece into World War II, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Winston Churchill, paid tribute to the heroic struggle put up by the Greeks. Here is a small excerpt from a speech made in the House of Commons by the wartime statesman.
You will remember how in November the Italian dictator fell upon the unoffending Greeks and without reason and without warning invaded their country, and how the Greek nation, reviving their classic fame, hurled his armies back at the double quick. Meanwhile, Hitler, who had been creeping and worming his way steadily forward, doping and poisoning and pinioning one after the other, Hungary, Romania, and Bulgaria, suddenly made it clear that he would come to the rescue of his fellow criminal. The lack of unity among the Balkan states had enabled him to build up a mighty army in their midst. While nearly all the Greek troops were busy beating the Italians, the tremendous German military machine suddenly towered up on their other frontier.
That was the voice of Winston Churchill speaking in the House of Commons on April 27, 1941. In our look back to this social, political, poignant, and historic time for Greece, a period that has left its powerful mark on every generation that followed, Tom Alexopoulos relates the moving World War II tale of how a Greek boy helped a New Zealand soldier and six others escape. The boy, who in his adult years went on to become a prominent lawyer on the world's plateau, had always been remembered as a legendary hero by the soldier he had saved and his family, and many decades later he met the soldier's wife and three generations of family in a heartwarmingly moving reunion.
The 97-year-old widow of a New Zealand soldier who led a dramatic escape from Nazi-occupied Greece was overcome with emotion last weekend when she came face-to-face with the Greek man who, as a 13-year-old boy, snuck food to her husband and six other New Zealand soldiers and helped them flee. George Bizos, the South African lawyer who rose to prominence as Nelson Mandela's counsel in the Rivonia treason trial, was that boy. His search for seven New Zealand soldiers he escaped with was featured on the front page of New Zealand's Weekend Herald. Freena Lewis was one of the number of readers touched by the story, and she could not settle until she met the man who helped save her husband, John, who died 8 years ago. Mrs. Lewis was an army nurse in World War II, stationed in Cairo, and she said it was remarkable to meet the Greek boy her late husband had spoken so much about. Their daughter, Brown Lewis, said the meeting with Mr. Bezos was a mind-blowing and unbelievably emotional experience for the family, three generations of whom were present. The story of my father's escape has been part of a whole experience, like having a precious heirloom you pass on from generation to generation, Ms. Lewis said. Her own daughter described the events as surreal. Mr. Bezos, who was attending the International Bar Association conference in Auckland this week, wept when the Herald introduced him to Mrs. Lewis and her family, more than 63 years after their dangerous escape on a disabled fishing boat in 1941. George Bezos, the lawyer, who ended up in South Africa and became part of the struggle against apartheid, said it took him 32 years to get a passport to leave his adopted country and return to Greece. Members of the Lewis family joined Mr. Bezos when the 75-year-old Greek South African was honored with a Human Rights Award at the conference.
That was Tom Alexopoulos with that inspiring and heartwarming story. Oh, that was our half-hour dedication to the October 28th Oichi Day celebration here in Greece. We'll be back with a half hour of easy listening music for the in Greek and foreign music. Coming up to the Athens Live program by Antonis Karayannakis. We'll be back shortly.
Athens International Radio, 104.4 FM.
Μου έχεις κάνει πολλά. Δεν είσαι ό,τι εγώ ζητώ. Δεν είσαι εσύ η δικιά μου ζωή. Ούτε αίσθημα αληθινό. Λάθος φιλιά, ένα ψέμα κι αυτά. Φύγε τώρα πριν φύγω εγώ. Εγώ μονάχα ξέρω πως όσο αγαπώ. Τρέμω όταν σ' ακούω κι όταν σε κοιτώ. Ναι, ό,τι κι αν πω. Και πάλι επεμβαίνει η αλήθεια εδώ. Το φως με προλαβαίνει πριν να σου κρυφτώ. Κρίμα πολύ να γλιστερά σαν γυαλί. Να με κόβεις με ό,τι πει. Για φτηνά δεν αξίζεις πολλά. Το ποτήρι σου και ό,τι πιείς. Λάθος φιλιά, ένα ψέμα κι αυτά. Φύγε τώρα πριν φύγω εγώ. Μα ό,τι κι αν πω. Εγώ μονάχα ξέρω πως όσα αγαπώ. Και τρέμω όταν σ' ακούω κι όταν σε κοιτώ. Ναι, ό,τι κι αν πω. Και πάλι επεμβαίνει η αλήθεια εδώ. Το φως με προλαβαίνει πριν να σου κρυφτώ. Το φως με προλαβαίνει πριν να σου κρυφτώ.
Loved me more with you. walk away.
Playing the hits of yesteryear just for you.
Though we gotta say goodbye for the summer, darling, I promise you this, I'll send you all my love every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. Guess it's gonna be a cold, lonely summer, but I'll fill the emptiness. I'll send you all my dreams every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. I'll see you in the sunlight, I'll hear your voice everywhere, I'll run to tenderly hold you, but darling, you won't be there. I don't wanna say goodbye the summer, knowing the love we'll miss. Oh, let us make a pledge to meet in September and seal it with a kiss. Kiss, sealed with a kiss, sealed with a kiss.
The radio sings to you,
radio,
radio loves you,
radio,
radio
really loves you.
Memories on wax take you there, it'll get you everywhere.
Πάει λίγος καιρός που φαινόσουν αλλιώς στα δικά μου τα μάτια και η καρδιά μου πλημμύριζε, από σένα ξεχύλιζε. Πάει λίγος καιρός που μιλούσε ο Θεός με την κάθε σου λέξη και εσύ έβαλες μάτια μου την καρδιά να διαλέξει. Τώρα η ζωή ένα αστείο πικρό, να έχεις φύγει εσύ και να φταίω εγώ. Δε μ' αγαπήσες στις παρέες να λες και με τα τραγούδια μου να κλαις. Τώρα η ζωή ένα αστείο πικρό, να έχεις φύγει εσύ και να φταίω εγώ. Δε μ' αγαπήσες στις παρέες να λες και με τα τραγούδια μου να κλαις.
ψέματα λες.
Wherever you go.
Πάει λίγος καιρός που δεν άναβα φως για να δω τη μορφή σου. Με τα χέρια μου σ' αγγίζα και τον κόσμο ζωγράφιζα. Πάει λίγος καιρός που σκεφτόμουν πως να σου πω σ' αγαπάω. Και εσύ φρόντισες μάτια μου όσο ζω να πονάω. Τώρα η ζωή ένα αστείο πικρό, να έχεις φύγει εσύ και να φταίω εγώ. Δε μ' αγάπησες στις παρέες να λες και με τα τραγούδια μου να κλαις. Τώρα η ζωή ένα αστείο πικρό, να έχεις φύγει εσύ και να φταίω εγώ. Δε μ' αγάπησες στις παρέες να λες και με τα τραγούδια μου να κλαις. Ψέματα λες. Τώρα η ζωή ένα αστείο πικρό, να έχεις φύγει εσύ και να φταίω εγώ. Δε μ' αγάπησες στις παρέες να λες και με τα τραγούδια μου να κλαις. Ψέματα λες.
Wherever you go. Just take a lively companion wherever you go. Take a portable radio. Take a portable radio.
Baby, I've been drifting away and dreaming all day. I'm holding you, touching you. The only thing I wanna do is be with you as close I can be. Let's make love. Let's make love more, baby.
Do you know what you do to me? Everything inside of me is wanting you and meeting you. make love all night long until our strength is gone. And hold on tight, just let go. I wanna feel you in my soul until.
that's new. It's really in the groove.
Silver screen and all its sadness.